Okay, Dr. Chan, well, what can you say first off just about this latest case of JCV?
Yeah, so we announced today for 2019 the first case of infection in an adult from Kingston, New Hampshire, who was recently hospitalized and diagnosed with actually two infections, Jamestown Canyon virus and Powassan virus infection. Now, just as a little bit of background, Jamestown Canyon virus is a mosquito-transmitted viral infection, and Powassan virus is a tick-transmitted virus infection. So these are two of a number of different both bacterial and viral infections that can be transmitted by mosquitoes, either mosquitoes or ticks, in New Hampshire. And I think that this serves as an important I think that this serves as an important reminder to residents and visitors in New Hampshire that from early spring, as soon as the snow melts and ticks and mosquitoes emerge through the summer and into the fall, until there's a couple hard frosts to kill mosquitoes, or until it drops below freezing and there's some snow when ticks are less active, these insects, mosquitoes and ticks, pose a risk to people and their health in New Hampshire.
What are some of the symptoms? I mean, if somebody were to come down, because I feel like these two things are very rare.
So to give you a little history, Jamestown Canyon was first identified as causing infection in humans back in the 1960s, and Powassan back in the 1950s. So these have been around for a number of decades, but we're still learning about these infections and how they impact human health. It's only more recently that we've been testing and looking for these infections. But Jamestown Canyon and Powassan both, like many of the other tick and mosquito-transmitted infections, can start with a very nonspecific fever illness, so people having fever and chills, headaches, muscle aches, joint aches, body aches. The thing with some of these infections, like Jamestown Canyon virus and Powassan, is that they can go on and they can cause a central nervous system infection, so meningitis or encephalitis. That's infection and swelling of the brain, and that can present with, you know, confusion, change in mental status, change in cognitive ability to think. And these infections, when they get into the central nervous system, can be very serious, and they can cause some lifelong impairment.
You said that these both were the first cases of the year, correct? When was the last time we even had anything from either of those?
Yeah, so we first identified Jamestown Canyon and Powassan infections in humans back in 2013. Since then, we've now had seven Jamestown Canyon virus infections, that's including the most recent individual, and four Powassan infections, again, including the most recent infection. Before this year, we had a number of infections with both Jamestown Canyon and Powassan back in 2017.
Anything else I didn't get?
Yeah, so the only thing I would mention is that, you know, because ticks and mosquitoes in New Hampshire pose a threat to health, it is important for people throughout the spring, summer, and fall to be taking precautions to protect themselves against both mosquito bites and tick bites. You know, we recommend when people are outdoors that they wear or they wear long pants and long sleeves, especially if they're going to be out in tall grass and tall brush where ticks like to live, or if they're outside at dawn and dusk when mosquitoes are most likely being active and biting. An insect repellent that's effective against ticks and mosquitoes should be applied to bare skin. That can include insect repellents with DEET or oil lemon eucalyptus formulations. And then there are some other measures that people can take around their house and around their yard. Ticks like, you know, tall grass, brushy habitat, and so people can take some landscaping steps to prevent ticks from coming into the yard where children and people might play and work. And then with mosquitoes, they like to breed in standing water, and so it's important for people to walk around their yards and look for areas of standing water, so pools, tarps, old toys, tires that can hold water where mosquitoes might be able to breed, and empty those out to prevent and help keep mosquito populations down.